Hi, today I'm going to mix bread dough at 600 RPM with a drill press. In addition, I'm going to mix a whole 5-pound bags of flour. Usually recipes come and give you a certain number of cups, but being myself, I lose count of how many cups of flour. So I decided that it would be nice if I could mix a whole 5-pound bag, which has, by the way, 17.5 cups of flour, 17 and a half cups of flour. Very few people write recipes for 17 and a half cups of flour. So you have to scale up the amount of the ingredients. At the end of the video, I'll show the basic math for that. So I'll show you the setup first, give you a few details about my drill press dough mixer, which is semi-automatic. There is a last feature that I didn't add to make it fully automatic because I still need it. I still need to use it once in a while as a drill press. I use it, let's say, maybe 4 times a year as a drill press, but as a dough mixer, I use it once every 2 weeks. So hold on here and I'll be back. First, I will install this hook. This hook that I made at 600 RPM, you don't want a hook that grabs too much dough. So this is as basic and simple and safe that I could make it. But it's part of an assembly. First, there is a washer that goes in first. Then, actually the washer doesn't go first. A small hose clamp goes in first. There is dough on everything if you see white. Then the washer goes in after that. And finally, I would say that's 1, 2, 3, 4, or 4 1/4 inch wooden disc goes on top of the washer. So we have hose clamp, washer, and wooden disc. And on top of that, I have another washer, which is covered with tape. And on top of that, before that, I have a rubber washer. Why rubber? Because I can squeeze it. I can add pressure to the rubber to make sure there is pressure on the wooden disc. All right, so all this goes inside the drill chuck and I lift everything up. And that's when I add the pressure on the rubber, when I lift everything up. But before I do that, why not I secure the hook into the drill chuck. And you have to make sure it's very tight, because that dough will offer lots of resistance. So to make sure it's tight, I lift on it while I torque it. One last try there. Tight it is. All right. Now I lift everything up and I try to apply pressure upward towards the rubber washer, kind of squeeze it in and push the hose clamp below the bottom washer and tighten the hose clamp, and that completes the installation of the hook assembly. And that's it. Now I could plug it and give it a test, but that's coming later. Alright, so let's take a quick pause there and I'll be back with more details about the mixing bowl itself. The mixing bowl, which is right there, upside down. Alright. Alright, you're looking at the mixing bowl. As I rotate this wooden platform, you can now see a wooden disc below. But if I rotate it back the way it was initially, you cannot see that wooden disc. In other words, the top platform does not equally rotate around. In other words, in more words, the pole itself does not rotate. The center of rotation is not in the middle of this platform. We have to upset this because we didn't want the bowl to touch the pole that's holding the drill press motor. So that's basically what's going on here. Okay? So as I turn everything upside down, you can see that this bowl is in the front part of this bottom platform. There is 3 inches right here between the bottom of the wooden disc, and there is basically a quarter of an inch right there. So that's the way the installation goes. Let me readjust the camera so you can see me putting this bowl, installing it at the base of the drill press. That's it. Just like that, it's in. Now we have options. We can rotate that platform and locate it where we want it to be. And the one thing you want to do is making sure that the height of the hook is perfect, so you can test that while it's empty and etc. So right now, I am going to get ready to pour in some ingredients, so hold on. All right, we are about ready to begin. First, I'll pour in all the liquid, stir it a little more because all the ingredients are in there. Then, all right, it's all done. Then I'll pour in a whole bag of, that is 5 pounds of all-purpose flour. Open it up right here. Ah, I should have pulled it open before, but I didn't. Here we go. The wind has calmed down a little bit, so I was worried about doing this outside. So I pull in some here, then rotate the bowl. You can watch the details of the bowl construction and how I made it rotate in another video. But here goes nothing. 13 and a half cups of flour without having to measure it. That goes. Okay, then at this point I have to raise the platform. Raise it up so that the bowl and the hook will almost meet. You don't want the hook to be touching the bowl. I hope I plug the power. If I didn't, I have to run and plug it. Now, here's what's going to happen from now on. When I turn this on, the hook rotates and mixes a lot of flour at the center. So I'll turn it off, let's say a few seconds or a minute later, and move some flour away from the hook, some well-mixed flour away, and try to get the stuff at the perimeter to move to the center. And that's it. So frequently I'll be putting my spoon down. So let me see if I can find a space for it here. If I would make it fall. Here goes nothing. Now it's almost water on me. Very soon that you can. Okay. I know for sure that the hook is taking the flour from the right and pushing it left. So I have to feed it to the right, kind of. I think I reached the point where I'll remix things, see what's at the center. Nothing tough yet, so I just let it roll on. When the dough starts getting stiff, the whole bowl starts rotating faster. I have to slow it down. Now it's starting to mix. We are spinning at, I can't see in the sun, I can't see the numbers, but I know it was set for about 600 RPM. I'll stop it right now, and I hope one of the cameras can see what's going on there. Alright, so you have to notice the time when this whole process started. And because I'm not going to stop the tape in between. And you see how long it takes. Thank you. it in there, it goes back here. There you go. Almost done there. Yep. I'll give it one last spin. And I have to go dump it and split it in four portions. Trying to mix some, to move some dough at the pavement, right next to the hook. I don't want to do that work later. Anyways, the wind and the flour mix pretty well. As you can see, it sprays a little flour every time the spoon bumps. The spoon bumps the dough. Okay, that's the last toughest part, I guess. That's when I usually start sweating, if you know what I mean. And if you do that one, one time, you can't do that a second time in the same day. But this procedure, you're watching. I can repeat that, I think, 10 times in one day, which gives you the potential of making bread commercially. I think that's about it. All right, so I'm going to get it out. I'll ask the machine to do one more leg by scraping the bottom. I have to move things away from the hook. Move things from the bottom to the middle into the center. Well, let's give it a try now, see what happens. Doesn't matter which one. I don't want to leave a lot of dough in the hook. Oh, that's it. There isn't much. I don't want that thing there. Okay. Now, you have to push it to one side. And see. Now, leave the whole platform. Let the screwdriver help sometimes. You slide between the wooden bottom and the metal platform. Yeah, it's coming out. No problem. Right here. That's what we got. So you like that? Now I got bread power. I can mix do-re-mi. Alright, see you later, guys. Watch the end of the video, please. So this video is about bread power that you get when you rewrite recipes for whole bags of flour.